Hello, I'm Professor Heidi, and I'm going to show you how to set up a base today. And I am joined by my husband, Brian, who's never held a base in his life, and we're going to see if we can get him to hold a base in his life. So, the first thing we need to do is set up the end pin. And there's two guidelines for setting up the end pin length. You want to have it high enough so that first finger in first position is level with the eye, and or, because some people are shaped funny, and or your knuckles on your right side or your right hand are level with the bridge. So we're going to get out a lot of end pin. Brian? Base has always got to be on the ground when you're taking the end pin out. It's too big otherwise. So I'm going to guess, based on how tall I am, and then base comes up, and go ahead and come up to the base.
Okay, on this side or the other side?
On this side, perfect. The base goes on the left, the person goes on the right. And so, not sure if you can see it in the camera, but there's a marking, a tape right here, this is probably the first time this base has ever been taped, that shows where first finger and first position goes. And a little bit closer, you can see that it's a little bit low, but pretty darn close. Let's do the secondary. So go ahead and stand in front of the base with your arm, your right arm. Yep, right arm. And see, his knuckles are just above the bridge, so we do need to raise this base a little bit. You're tall. And knuckles?
So pretty close.
Pretty close. We'll take that. And eyeball?
Yeah.
Okay, that looks good to me. All right. So once the end pin is right, there are five steps to good posture. You put your hand, on left hand, on the saddle of the neck, and you're standing behind the base. Good. And then you walk up to the base. And then you lean the base into your hip, your inner hip, so your inner left hip, right back here. Good. And you want to be able to hold the base in the hip with, and not let it be pushed away like this. So the base is firmly locked in his hip, it's not getting pushed away. Alright, and you want to stand up straight, feet firmly attached to the ground. I'm checking on my notes here. And once you've got that set up, you want to try and balance the base with no hands. And I will just keep an eye on the base. So just in case it does fall, we'll be okay.
Try balancing with no hands, so
yep.
Walking forward just a little bit. Yeah, that's pretty close.
Yeah, it's pretty close indeed. Good. So we're going to go through a general checklist. Are both of your feet firmly on the ground?
Yes.
Good. Is your weight evenly distributed?
Yes.
Is the base leaning into your body a little bit?
A little bit, yeah.
Good. Is your eye at the first finger tape marking?
Yeah.
Let's see, can your right hand easily reach the end of the fingerboard?
Oh yeah, totally.
Very good. Can your left hand access all the high and the low notes? So low notes, and then try some of the high notes. Good. And is the base connecting to you at a 90 degree angle? So in the back, the base is going to be kind of a 90 degree angle with your body. And so, yeah, that looks like about a 90 degree angle. And are you generally comfortable?
Yeah.
Good, very good. So, once you're set up, then you'll be able to start playing pizzicato. I'm going to have you play just a little bit of pizzicato by putting your thumb, your right thumb, on the side of the fingerboard that's closest to you, and then putting the inside of your finger, so the inside of your finger, good, on the string, and then tugging, yeah, and pulling it towards you. Try a couple of different strings. And a little bit, pull a little bit harder, the bass can handle it. There you go. Thank you very much, Brian.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is Ben Howdy set up a bass.